I'm Zane Lamprey at the Wine and Spirits Wholesalers of America 71st Annual Convention here in beautiful Las Vegas with the winner of the Hoptails competition, Troy Clarke.
Thank you.
Let's start off by something. This caught me off guard because I was reading your bio here. It says here, and just says, he also serves as the President of the United States.
Bartenders Guild for Massachusetts.
Oh, there was not supposed to be a period there. Okay,
no,
all right.
No, no.
So he serves as the President of the United States.
I'm the President.
Bartender.
I'm acting for Barack Obama.
That is amazing. You do so much. I think people, what needs to resonate with people is how much competition there was for this competition and what a big deal it was to win it. How many bartenders were in it yesterday?
I think there was 12 people that were selected to compete.
Exactly. 12 of the best to be there,
yeah.
You among them, and then winning it, it's a big deal. I was there, I watched it. Very impressed. Okay, so let's talk about your drink. What is the name of it? Did we talk about the name?
It's called Winter Vacation.
Winter Vacation. So you are the mixologist for Martin Yeti companies.
Yes.
Which is a distribution company.
Yes.
And the spirit that you use was from Proximo. So the Dobel is from Proximo Spirits.
Yes. We represent Proximo in our portfolio.
Just a big happy family.
Yes.
How happy are they? You probably should get, and I'll write you a letter of recommendation, you should probably get some sort of bonus.
Maybe a bottle of tequila.
Wouldn't that be fantastic? You can take this one.
Hey, you know, they're all signed.
That's right. Okay, so the drink that you made that won the competition yesterday, I have the ingredients here. Why don't you tell me what they were? Why don't I quiz you?
Yes, quiz me. So Winter Vacation, the drink was inspired from the Northeast, the cold weather that we were having.
Ah.
So that's really where it all came about, the inspiration. It starts off with the glass being rinsed with this triple-peated scotch.
Okay.
So really, really intense smoky flavors to represent the fire that has to heat, keep you warm in the winter.
Got it.
The next element was the tequila. Where we used about an ounce of the Dobel tequila reposado, about a half ounce of lime juice and a half ounce of light agave nectar. And they were to represent where you were traveling, Mexico.
Okay.
The lime juice was to represent fresh, warm, things are growing, it's kind of that summer feel.
Okay.
And then the sweetness of the agave is kind of to kind of bring it all in. You're like, this is amazing, total awesome, right?
Yeah.
I'm in this place that I want to be. It's freezing where I live.
Right.
And then right on the back.
By the way,
end,
which is Boston. And we're in Vegas, and it's about 90 degrees outside right now.
Exactly.
So it's literally to take you from someplace cold and transport you figuratively.
Yeah.
Now you're
so
literally.
So you're at the bar, you have this, and then the next thing you know, you get hit with this malt double black IPA from Rhode Island, a local beer that's brewed there, and it brings you back home. Immediately with this malty, toasty caramel finishing really, really soft. And then you see the lime floating in the glass to remind you of the water and the trip to Mexico. So you finish on a high note.
So because it was called Hoptails,
yes.
It's sort of a play on cocktails and beer. Hops because hops are in beer.
Yes.
But it doesn't mean that you had to use a hoppy beer. So you have a double IPA.
Correct.
It's very hoppy.
Intense hoppy, yeah.
Why did you choose
Bunny Rabbit on steroids.
That's what this is?
No. Hops.
Yeah. it's Vegas, man. I haven't slept very much. Now, what's amazing, we talked before we started doing this interview.
Yes.
And you told me that you got to bed kind of early last night.
Yeah.
You retired. You went back to your room.
Yes.
Because you have two competitions today?
Yes, two more.
Two more to compete in.
Yes.
So your head right now, even though you're talking to me, is in this next competition. Because you're not happy.
Oh, I'm here right now.
Well, you are here.
Yes.
You are here, but you have this coming up.
Yes.
So you went back to your room early last night.
Yes.
To work on your cocktails for today.
Yeah, I went back around 1 a.m.
1 a.m. That is
pretty early for Vegas.
Actually, well, as far as the morning is concerned, you can't get much earlier than that.
Yeah, it's 4 a.m. my time.
So
it's like getting up early.
Fair enough. So then you went to bed at what time?
Probably around 4 a.m. Vegas time.
Okay. And then you woke up at what time?
Like 5:30 Vegas time.
I love it. I mean, this is, it's exciting because this is a big deal. And you have this, you know, you have the accolades, you have this. But I mean, it really is a victory that will live on forever because you won it. Once you won it, you're a winner. You get to come back in like where you get like a green jacket or something? Or is that the Masters?
That's the Masters.
That's the Masters, yeah. So no green jacket.
I think they give hot pink for Hoptails.
Hoptails?
Hot pink jackets.
Okay, so very peaty, very hoppy. Why did you choose the Dobel? I mean, you obviously there's plenty of tequilas to choose from, so why did you choose this one?
Absolutely. Well, this is considered one of a premium tequila products. As you can see, it's a clear tequila.
Yeah.
So most would think it's Blanco, but it's actually a Reposado. So Reposado meaning rested.
That's been then filtered?
Aged, and it's filtered.
Oh, okay.
So you don't get the color, but you get the flavor.
It's good.
Really, really nice. Two times distilled. And what they do is they age it in white Hungarian oak.
Okay.
So tighter grain actually allows for more, like medium tannin, so really nice structure, so it can hold up against the beer and
Got
the
it.
Scotch and still shine through. And that's really one of the reasons why I selected this tequila. I wanted a Reposado, but I wanted it, and I didn't need more color.
Right.
The color's coming through with the beer.
Right.
And I wanted something that could withstand the hops and the malt.
You, if you would have used a Blanco, like a white, you could have had, the flavor could have gotten lost because
would have been too light.
These are really overpowering.
You need something that has a little bit more flavor and wood and can withhold that.
What I like that you did in the cocktail, and I tried it yesterday, is that all these flavors are present. And I think one of the things and I think mixology is sort of saving this a little bit, is that people think that the best compliment they can give you as a customer is that, wow, I can't even taste the alcohol. I can't even taste the spirit that it was made with. They want it just to disappear. But with this, you could taste those, and the way that they were blended, it just brought them out. I think that the agave syrup sort of mellowed them out a little bit, but you could still taste them.
Well, the agave was a light agave, so mm-hmm. it's more of a neutral just to kind of enhance
right.
And help lift it up, but
right.
not play a role in just tasting agave.
Right.
So when you use certain different, you know, a raw one, it could be too overpowering.
Right.
You know, the style of cocktails that I like to make are very food friendly, where you can taste each element of the drink in different stages of your meal.
Yeah.
But not letting one overpower the other.
Yeah. No, it was fantastic. Very good. Nice job.
Thank you.
You have more competitions to win, so
yes.
I might see you later. Thank you for joining us. We're gonna go drink.